So here's one way to define find element using index. In the case where the element does exist in P, index gives us exactly the result we want. So we can use an if statement, check that T is in P using T in P. And then if it is, the block for the if returns that value. It returns P.index T. For the else clause, the element did not exist in P, so we return -1. Here's another way we might define find element using index. Instead of checking if T is in P this time, we'll check if T is not in P. If T is not in P, well then we know the result is -1. We can return -1 right away. If we reach the next statement, then we know that T is in P, and we can return the result of P.index passing in T. So we've seen four different ways to define the find element method. They all have the same behavior, but we've defined it once with a while loop, once with a for loop, and two different ways using the index method. When we use index, we need to use an if statement as well to make sure that we produce the right result for the case where the element is not in P.